Hear me out. Ivermectin is a miracle drug. Not for COVID-19. We did the research. It doesn't do a whole heck of a lot against viruses in general or the one that causes COVID-19 in particular, and the rest of this video will not be about that. What ivermectin does do is kick parasitic infections to the curb in a way that's safe, effective, and cheap. For a huge number of diseases, it is a total wonder drug. Which is why scientists are now trying it against a disease that has dogged humanity since the Stone Age and killed up to 300 million people in the 20th century alone. Our best antiparasitic drug is stepping into the ring against malaria. So as the starting bell rings, let's see who has the better odds in this fight. Ivermectin has a proven track record against parasites. When it was discovered, it was revolutionary. And that's because it was the first drug to earn the fancy title of endecticide, which means it can kill parasites that live both inside and outside of you. A lot of internal parasites, like roundworm, hang around in your GI tract, clinging to your intestines to soak up the nutrients. But they are no match for ivermectin, which messes with the worm's nerve function at certain stages of development, leading to paralysis and death. And parasites that attack you from the outside, like scabies burrowing into your skin, are also paralyzed and killed by ivermectin. So ivermectin is great for treating a broad range of parasites. But what about a parasite that has probably killed about a billion people throughout history, and that has teamed up with another nasty pest? Of course, I am talking about Plasmodium, which is the causative agent of malaria. Technically, there are four major species of Plasmodium, but they all cause malaria, and they all have a sidekick, the Anopheles mosquito. Immature Plasmodia develop inside of mosquitoes, and then the mosquito come to us and they take a blood meal. During the blood meal, they break your skin, and the Plasmodia inside their saliva get into your bloodstream. Then the Plasmodia invade your liver cells before infecting your red blood cells. After lots of replicating, the Plasmodia eventually burst free of the red blood cells, causing malaria symptoms like cyclic fever. This disease has resisted treatment for centuries, and while ivermectin is good, scientists wanted to know if it was kills parasites that fly on a Trojan horse and hide in your red blood cells good. So let's start with the bigger guys, the mosquitoes. Lab data shows that when people have ivermectin in their systems during a blood meal, mosquitoes who bite them die much quicker than when they bite untreated folks. It's basically just poisoning your blood so that anything that bites you will eventually drop dead, which is metal. A 2015 study found that 2 days after a meal, only around 52% of the mosquitoes were still alive, compared to over 97% on the ivermectin-free blood diet. Plus, it completely stopped them from laying eggs. That means mosquitoes reproduce less and they die faster. And since Plasmodium needs mosquitoes to infect humans, that could theoretically mean fewer malaria infections. But it would be really stellar if ivermectin directly harmed Plasmodium, which it does. Ivermectin messes with the parasite's ability to move stuff in and out of its cells, leading to parasite death. Beyond that, Plasmodium can reproduce sexually and asexually, and some studies have found that both are inhibited by ivermectin. Now, other studies haven't found the same anti-malaria effect, but with some evidence of ivermectin harming mosquitoes and Plasmodium parasites alike, there's buzz about using it for a mass drug administration, or MDA. MDA is when a drug is given to everyone in a geographic area, regardless of their disease status, in order to help prevent or treat infection. Now, that might sound pretty extreme, but it can be a super useful tool in health emergencies like the Ebola outbreak in West Africa or in places with high infection rates like parasitic worms in tropical areas. There's no question that we need new tools to combat malaria, but in order for MDA to be considered, the drug also has to meet certain criteria. Safety, convenience, and cost all need to be factored in when considering MDA. Since ivermectin already has been used for decades, we know it is generally safe, barring overdoses or drug interactions, which MDA protocols would take care to prevent. It's also convenient, available as a tablet, and most MDA designs only need 3 days of ivermectin administration each month. And even though its cost can vary, ivermectin is generally a pretty cheap option. We are right now losing ground in the fight against malaria. Ivermectin ticks all of the boxes for MDA and has the potential to act as a double whammy. The shortening effect it has on mosquito lifespans make it seem like it would be highly effective. One research team estimated that 3 doses of ivermectin over 3 months could reduce new cases of malaria by 71% and the general prevalence of cases by over 1/3. But before we look into how it's all going to happen in the real world, all science needs funding, so let's take a quick break.
Thank you for watching this SciShow video. When you and your friends watch our shows, it helps us continue to make free educational stuff that you love. But that's not the only way to show your support for SciShow. We have a whole merch store. And right now, the best SciShow merch is on sale. The real ones know that we've made dozens of awesome space pins over the years, like the Arecibo commemoration pin, RIP, or our solar system's very own sun absolutely wailing on an electric guitar, because it's metal. And all of those pins are discounted 20%, but only through August 15th. And great stuff like puzzles and postcards are 45% off, so get them while they're hot. All at complexly.store/collections/sale.
The hype over ivermectin as malaria treatment is real, and if real-world data could replicate that, it would be a major win in the human versus parasite fight. Unfortunately, in the real world, the results have been mixed. So in 2019 and 2020, a phase 3 clinical trial began that used this exact dosing in 7 villages in Burkina Faso, with 7 others acting as controls. They focused their study on children, specifically. And despite those very promising projections, the study found that malaria incidence did not significantly differ between the ivermectin and control group children, nor did ivermectin treatment decrease the number of infectious bites. As for mosquitoes, lifespans were shorter for mosquitoes captured a week after drug administration, but that did not hold true for those captured 3 weeks post-administration. Not very promising results, but to be fair, the study experienced what you might call a complicating factor. See, a few months into the trial, the government swept through and gave all the villages new bed nets slathered in insecticides, probably decreasing the incidence of malaria in both groups. Great for the study participants overall. Maybe frustrating, though, when you're the one trying to do science. Luckily, the study was not a total wash. Malaria can cause low hemoglobin levels, since the parasites rip apart the red blood cells in your blood. In the study, children who received ivermectin had significantly higher hemoglobin levels, which might signal lower parasite burden. A trial in Gambia that didn't face those same challenges as the other study actually fared much better. It found that ivermectin administered in combination with another anti-malaria drug called this significantly reduced malaria prevalence. I'm talking about less than half of the cases compared to the control group. But a different study, published in 2025, showed no difference in the rates compared to just using that other anti-malarial drug. And a 2021 review concluded that there was just not enough evidence yet to say whether ivermectin is actually effective at fighting malaria in humans. Research is ongoing, so we will have to see how more trials wrap up, but something we do know is that resistance to ivermectin can develop, making it useless over time. Which is where a drug that kills mosquitoes even better than ivermectin comes in. Currently used to treat rare metabolic disorders, nitisinone might be the next big step in malaria research. This state-of-the-art new mosquito poisoning development works by inhibiting an enzyme that mosquitoes need to actually digest their blood meal, and would be administered in a similar way to ivermectin. Nitisinone's anti-mosquito abilities are newly discovered, but there is a lot of excitement behind this drug, too. Ivermectin may or may not prove effective against malaria, but up against a disease that affects hundreds of millions of people each year, it's worth trying everything we've got. So whether it's ivermectin, nitisinone, or something else that has yet to be discovered, if it can fight malaria, then that is a major research win. And bonus points if it can take out some of those pesky mosquitoes, too.